Hello, everyone.
Hi, 大家早上好。
Welcome to our very first bilingual service.
欢迎来到我们第一个双语聚会。
Woo! And a big shout out to those at Suntec too.
我们要欢迎那些在新达成的。
And those watching online.
还有那些在线上的。
And just a reminder that today is Holy Council. Do remember to prepare your elements.
那提醒大家，今天是我们守圣餐的周末。那些在家中的，请记得预备你的圣餐的材料。
So, hi everyone, my name is Pastor Charmaine.
他的名字是心灵牧师。
And he is Pastor Willow.
我是韦龙牧师。
Yeah, yeah. So, in case you do not know,
如果你不知道的话，
he's my cell leader.
啊，我是他的组长。
So I must be 乖。
啊，所以他要很乖。
Joking.
对对对，谁、yeah. 谁是你的组长，你都要乖。
对对对。Yeah, I'm always very grateful for him.
我非常感谢他。
I'll never forget many years back.
我记得很多年前。
We are supposed to fly for a church conference.
我们要去一个外国的大会。
We are supposed to check in at 5:30 a.m. at airport.
我们早凌晨五点半要在机场集合。
Guess where I am at 5:30 a.m.
我五点半的时候在哪里呢？
我在睡觉。
她在睡觉。She was sleeping.
Yeah. So they all try to call my handphone.
他们很多人打我的手机的电话。
But it's in silent mode.
可是那时候是静音模式。
So nobody can get me.
所以没有人找得到我。
But he got a brilliant idea suddenly.
他突然间他有一个启发。
EFD.
他说去找我们教会的那个资料的存
库。Got my house number.
有他家里的电话号码。
So that's when they call me.
他就打去我的家。
Finally, my father pick up.
我爸爸就接电话。
他讲一个话，我不可以讲他在。
他的爸爸就讲了一句我们今天不能讲出来的一句话。
去厕所那个话，对。
去厕所用的那个字。他就什么话都没有说，放下电话。
Then he F1 drive me all the way to Changi Airport.
他就快速的把我载到飞机场。
And I managed to check in.
他刚好赶得上飞机。
So thank God for him.
对，感谢我。
Yeah, 对对。All right, so maybe you can find somebody.
可能你现在可以找一个搭档。
Why don't you share one Thanksgiving that you have?
你跟他分享一个你感恩的一件事。
Before we start our worship.
在我们今天还没开始我们的敬拜的时候。
Pastor Willow, got any Thanksgiving? After I share my Thanksgiving for you, yeah.
今天在台上我有一个搭档，平时只是我一个人，今天有多一个搭档，我很感恩。
He very thankful that he got a buddy, right? to share stage with him, yes.
那你感恩的是什么呢？
我刚才讲了，讲这么长也是。
哦，好。
Talk so long, yeah. Not bad, 我的华语。
对对对。
Actually, my Chinese score better than my English.
哇，很厉害，那是一个奇迹。哎，对。
对对。All right, are you ready to worship the Lord?
你预备好敬拜上帝了没有
？Why don't we stand right now?
我们一起起立。
We're going to worship God both in English and Chinese song.
我们要以英语跟华语的诗歌来敬拜上帝。可是当英语的歌词出现在荧幕的时候呢，会有中文字的翻译来告诉你那个意思是什么。可能唱不出那个歌词，可是那个意思你会知道。
对对对。So when it's Chinese song, there'll be English meaning also. So in case you do not understand the word, you know what it means also. Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah. So are you ready?
你预备好了没有？
Why don't we give praise to the Lord, amen?
我们把赞美都归给他。
And let's invite the presence of God in this place. Lord, we thank you, Lord.
主，我们感谢你，我们尊崇你。
To worship you, Lord.
能敬拜你是我们的福气。
May your presence fill this house.
让我们的赞美充满这个地方。
Because this is your house,
Lord. 因为这是你的院，你的家。
In Jesus' name, we pray.
奉耶稣的名祷告。
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. 今天真的很兴奋，我们能一起一家人一起来敬拜主 ，Amen。
Amen。
我们还没敬拜主的时候，我会数到三，然后我们就大大的、热烈的、大声的鼓掌、跳舞、拍手来敬拜神 ，OK？ 你们还不要拍手 ，OK？ 我们给 Pastor Roger 先讲话。
Yeah, so good to be able to worship the Lord together,、yes. and in a while's time, we're going to give God our loudest clap offering, Amen. Amen. So if you are ready here.At TC and over there, Suntec City, at the count of three, let's do that. Ready?
你们准备好了吗？
准备好了。
Yes.
Here we go. One, two, and three.
我们拍手，Hallelujah! what to say, Lord. It's you gave me life, and I can't explain just how much you mean to me now. You saved me, Lord. I give all that I am to you, and every day I can be light that shines your name.
With what's next? Oh, 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 for the God I know. God isn't finished yet. If He did it before, He can do it again. So I trust Him with what comes next. For the God I know is known for faithfulness. Oh, 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 oh. And my hindsight says I can trust Him with what's next. Oh, 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 oh. For the God I know is known for faithfulness. Oh, 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 oh. I don't need to know what the future says, 'cause if the past could talk, it would tell me this. And my God hasn't finished yet. If He did it before, He can do it again. So I trust Him with what comes next.
Somebody who really walked close to God was none other than, you know, in the Old Testament, King David. You know, despite of all that he was going through, having to run away from King Saul and even from his own son, David remained resolved. He stayed close to God, followed and walked all the days of his life close to God. You know, and we thank God for that. Even for today, we have the Holy Spirit. God has given us the Holy Spirit. He is our comforter, our friend, He's our peace. And despite what we're going through, let's just desire more of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. 圣经告诉我们说，大卫王是一个合乎神心意的人。他无论什么事情，什么困难，他都要依靠神，他都来亲近神。今天神住在我们里面， Amen. Amen. 好不好？我们高举我们双手， Let's lift up our hands. 今天我们来告诉神，神啊，你是我的依靠，你是我的盼望。好不好？我们今天一起来渴慕更多经历神的同在。Yes, Lord, we want to desire more of you.Spirit sound, rushing wind, fire of God falling in. Holy Ghost, breathe on us, we pray. As we repent, turn from sin, revival embers smoldering. Breath of God, fan us into flame.We need a fresh wind, the fragrance of heaven. Pour your spirit out, pour your spirit out. Come and pour. King and kingdom, come is what we pray. one voice.
Never in me, prophesy and sing.
Amen.
We can hear the wind blowing, blowing, blowing.
能不能就让我留在你
去，只想日夜在你眼中献上敬拜，全心全意来爱你。是的主，我们属于你，
我属于你，你是我永远的福分，只想日夜在你殿中献上敬拜，定睛在你的荣美，世上一切别黯淡，除你以外我还能有谁。是我永远的福分，只想日夜在你殿中献上敬拜，定睛在你的荣美，世上一切别黯淡，除你以外我还能有谁。
For you are a God who is faithful. 是的，主，我们赞美你，你是信实的，你是信实的神。Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, we praise you. Amen. Amazing grace.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. My chains are gone, I've been set free, my God, my
Lord, we thank you for your love.
主，我们感谢你对我们的爱。
We thank you for your grace.
谢谢你的恩典。
If not for what you have done on the cross,
就是因为你在耶稣十字架上所成就的。
When I'm unable to draw near to you,
让我们能够亲近你。
Lord, we want to thank you, Lord, for your grace.
主，我们要感谢你对我们的恩典。
And right now, we're going to enter into a very important time.
现在我们要进入一段非常重要的时段。
And that's partaking of our Lord's Supper.
就是我们要守圣餐了。
Can you right now just prepare our elements?
我们现在来预备我们的圣餐材料。
If you do not have, you can just raise your hand, and we'll have ushers to pass it to you.
如果你的圣餐材料不在你的手上，请跟我们挥手，会有人把材料交在你的手中。
Now, as you peel off your first layer,
当你把第一层胶纸撕开。
It reveals the bread.
你会看到这个饼。
It represents the body of Christ.
代表的是耶稣的身体。
Which was broken for us.
为了我们而破碎。
As you peel off the second layer.
当你撕开第二层胶纸。
It reveals the cup.
就是那个杯。
Which represents the blood of Christ which bled for us.
代表的是耶稣为我们流的宝血。
So right now, I'm going to give you some time.
现在我给大家一段时间。
To just have this time with the Lord to really.Draw near to him.
让你亲近神。
Can I invite all of us right now to just kneel before the Lord?
我邀请大家，方便的话可以一起跪下。
With some of you here, you feel distance from the Lord.
我们当中有一些人，可能你觉得你离上帝很疏远。
You feel unworthy.
你认为你不配得。
Lord says today, come back to Him.
主耶稣今天对你说，回来吧，孩子。
With some of you here, you've sinned against the Lord.
有些人在当中，你犯了罪。
May you use this time to confess our sin.
你就用这段时间在神的面前悔改认罪。
With some of you, you're asking God for a miracle.
有些人，你对上帝祈求一个奇迹。
Use this time to seek Him, to ask from Him.
你用这段时间来呼求他，寻求他。
Lord, this day we want to thank you for what you have done on the cross.
主，今天我们要感谢你在十字架上为我们做的一切。
Lord, may you always remember.
主，愿你帮助我们永远记得。
And Lord, this day we come before you.
主，今天我们来到你的跟前。
We confess our sins.
我们认罪悔改。
Lord, please forgive us.
主，求你饶恕我们的罪。
And I pray for every one of us here.
我为我们每一位都祷告。
That Lord, we are no longer slaves to our sin.
我们不再成为罪的奴隶。
But we are sons and daughters of the living God.
我们是上帝的儿女。
You know, 1 Corinthians 11 verse 23 says, For I received from the Lord what I also pass on to you. The Lord Jesus, on the night he was betrayed, took bread, and we have given thanks. He broke it and said, This is my body which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me.
哥林多前书11章23到24节说，主耶稣在被卖的那一夜，他举起杯来，祝谢了就说，这是我的饼，为的是你们而舍的。
Can we right now partake the bread together?
我们一起来领受这个饼。
Lord, we thank you.For the body which was broken for us.
主，我们感谢你为我们舍的身体。
Because of your stripes that's been inflicted on your body.
因为你受的鞭伤。
There's the power of healing.
我们能领受医治的大能。
Release over us.
我们能，你能，你把医治释放在我们的身上。
Whether it's emotionally, spiritually, or physically.
无论是在情感，在属灵，在我们的情感上。
Right now we receive the healing that comes from you.
今天我们领受从你而来的医治。
Lord, we thank you, Lord.
主，我们感谢你。
In 1 Corinthians 11, 25, it says, In the same way, after supper, he took the cup, saying, This cup is a new covenant in my blood. Do this whenever you drink of it in remembrance of me.
饭后，耶稣也照样拿起杯来说，这杯是用我的血所立的新约。你们每逢喝这杯的时候，要如此行，为的是纪念我。
Let's partake of the cup together right now.
我们一起来领受这杯。
Lord, we thank you for the blood that you have shed for us.
主，我们感谢你为我们流的宝血。
Indeed, we are forgiven.
的确，我们得饶恕。
That through your grace,
靠着你的恩典，
through your mercy,
靠着你的怜悯，
we declare that we are righteous before you.
我们宣告我们在你的面前是公义
的。And because of this, we can rise up in victory.
如此，我们可以兴起来在你的圣
灵当中。So Lord, this day we praise you, Lord.
所以主，今天我们敬拜你。
In Jesus' most precious name, we all pray.
奉耶稣尊贵的名祷告。
Amen. Can we rise in praise? Amen.
我们一起起立来赞美主。
You know, because of His amazing grace.
因着上帝奇妙的恩典。
We can come together as a church.
我们才可以一起成为一个教会，来到他的面前。
To worship Him.
来敬拜他。
No, today is our third day for the 40 days of Love Singapore prayer and fasting.
今天是我们爱新加坡运动四十天禁食祷告的第三天。
And just nice, today talks about giving thanks to our church.
今天呢，他非常巧妙的，就是说要感谢我们的教会。
Are you proud to be in FCBC?
你觉得在建新基督教会感到骄傲吗？
No, I wasn't born in this church.
我不是在这间教会诞生的。
But 14 years ago, I came to this church.
可是14年前我来到这间教会。
And it was my greatest decision ever, the best choice ever.
这是我生命中最重要、最美好的决定。
And I tell myself that I want to grow old in this church.
我告诉我自己，我要在这间教会里面变老。
Because I'm so proud to be in FCBC.
因为我在这间教会感到非常的骄傲。
And I encourage all of us here.
我要鼓励大家。
To really.Not just be proud, but to pray for our church.
不单单只是为着我们的教会而骄傲，也要为教会祷告。
As together as one to build this church up.
我们要合一的来建立这间教会。
So we're going to enter in this time of prayer.
所以现在我们要进入祷告的时间。
You can find one partner.
你可以找一个搭档跟你一起祷告。
To pray together for our church.
为着我们的教会而祷告。
To give thanks for our church.
为着我们的教会而感恩。
To say that Lord, this day use me to be part of this church to build this church up.
跟主说，主啊，今天你使用我来建造这个教会。
And let's pray for our leadership also.
也为我们的领袖们祷告。
Our senior pastor.
我们的主任牧师。
Let's pray for your cell leaders.
为你的组长祷告。
Pray for your cell group.
为着你的小组长祷告。
That together as one.
那我们一起合一的。
We'll make FCB stronger than before. Amen.
使建新基督教会比以前更加的强壮。
So why don't find one partner right now and just pray together.
所以你找一个搭档，现在一起来祷告。
Lord, this day we want to thank you.
主，今天我们要感谢你。
For this privilege to come together as one.
让我们有这个机会能合一的聚集在一起。
To worship you.
来敬拜你。
To be a family here, Lord.
成为你的家属。
Lord, I want to pray that Lord may we continue to grow from strength to strength.
主，我祷告你让我们力上加力。
And we pray for every FCBC member here.
我为着我们教会的每一位成员祷告。
The Lord will be excited.
我们会充满着热忱。
For what is to come for our church.
因着你为我们所预备的。
So Lord, we thank you, Lord.
所以我们感谢你。
May your presence continue to dwell in this place.
愿你的同在继续的在这里。
In Jesus' name we pray.
我们奉耶稣的名祷告。
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Why don't you turn to the person next to you and say, "I thank God for you."
跟你旁边的人说，我为着你而感恩。
And find that person and speak in Chinese, say, 我谢谢你。
然后对你旁边另外一个人说，我为你而感恩。
对，我为你而感恩，对，我谢谢你。不跟 Chinese.、Yeah. Are you happy to be in the house of the God? House of God?
你在神的院中开心吗
？Yeah, I'm so happy. It's a privilege, all right?
啊，这是非常开心，这是我们的福气。
And right now we're going to enter the special time of worship.
现在我们要用另外一种方式来敬拜上帝。
It's our offering time.
就是我们要给奉献。
So let's prepare our hearts.
我们来预备我们的心。
But before that, I'm going to give some announcement regarding offering.
可是在这之前呢，我要给大家一些报告。
You know, you can give online at fcbc.org.sg/offering.
你可以在这个荧幕上的这个链接呢，去给你的奉献。
And the link is available at all times.
啊，这个链接上呢是24小时7天都开放着的。
So in case you can't log in today, you can log in any time of the week.
如果你今天呢不能进去的话，任何别的时段也可以去这个网站。
Alternatively, you can scan either of the PayNow QR code as shown now.
那不然的话，你也可以用这个二维码的扫描器来扫这个二维码。
So for the red box is our tithes and offering.
这个红色的方格子是我们立场的十一奉献。
And the blue box is our mission faith pledge.
那蓝色的方格子是我们宣教信心奉献。
So the mission faith pledge is over and above the general offering. It's used for the overarching purpose of mission, humanitarian, social initiative, both local and overseas that promote the gospel of Christ.
这个宣教的信心奉献呢，是超越我们立场的十一奉献，来在我们的外地去宣教，或者是这些救济人的这些事工上的服事。
So make sure you're using your bank mobile app and not your regular QR code scan.
那要记得的就是要用我们银行手机程序的这个扫描器来扫描这个二维码。
All right, come, let's turn our eyes to the Lord as we pray to give unto the Lord.
那我们现在定睛仰望我们的神，把借着祷告把这个奉献交托给他。
Lord, we thank you for this privilege to give unto you.
主，我们感谢你给我们这个能力能奉献给你。
Use it, Lord, to further your kingdom.
求你使用这奉献来扩张你的国度。
May we always choose to seek first your kingdom, Lord.
愿我们在任何的事上都尊你为先。
In Jesus' name we pray.
奉耶稣的名祷告。
Amen.
Amen.
All right, I have a few announcements.
我有几项大报告要跟大家分享。
I'll share all in English first for the announcement, then we'll translate in Chinese.
我会先用英语来给这个报告，然后才会用中文。
The first up is service updates.Our G-Kids services have fully resumed both at Touch Center and Suntec from this weekend. Yeah, all right. Yeah. Okay, so do note that pre-registration and password are no longer needed to book tickets for G-Kids services. In order to prevent congestion, all right, all G-Kids service will start 10 minutes earlier at the following timing. So for Saturday last night, it was 7:20 p.m. And today, Sunday, is 9:50 a.m.Tickets open for booking at 9 p.m. every Wednesday at fcbc.org.sg/ticketing. Also, for safe entry, check-in, bow, trace together app or token is still required, all right, for vaccination differentiated services. So do remember to bring them along. And more info on our services can be found on our websites.
那第一个报告是有关于我们聚会的最新消息。从这个周末开始，我们的 G 代儿童的聚会在触爱中心和新达成已经全面恢复进行了。来，我们鼓掌给主。那请注意，你不再需要预先登记和密码来预订 G 代儿童的这个聚会的门票。所有 G 代儿童的聚会将提前十分钟开始，以避免人潮拥挤。那新的 G 代儿童聚会的时间如下：星期六是在晚上7:20，星期日是在早上9:50。门票将于每个星期三晚上9:00。在 fcbc.org.sg 那边开放预订。那实施这个疫苗接种差异化安全管理措施的聚会的所有出席者，还是需要透过合力追踪应用程序，或者你携带这个便带携那个token 来进行。记得的就是请注意，任何其他的资料可以去我们教会的网站。
Okay, next up is our Love Singapore 40 Days of Prayer. It has kicked off, all right, since Friday, right, 1st July. It's going to all the way till 9 August. We're going to pray through the book of Philippians based on the theme, To Live is Christ. The site is now live and prayer entries are available in English and Chinese.
第二项报告是有关于爱新加坡40天的祷告与禁食。 这个祷告已经是已经开始了，将从今年7月1日至8月9日，我们会根据今年的主题“活着就是基督”一同研读腓立比书与祷告。那英语和华语的祷告事项已刊载在40天2022的网址上。So
more info announcements mentioned today, as well as these events. If coming up this month, can be found on our website.
最后一项报告是关于如果你要知道我们这个月份的任何的活动，可以去这个荧幕上的网址那里参考。Are
you ready for the word of God?
你预备好来聆听神的话语了吗？
Are you ready for the word of God?
你预备好聆听神的话语了吗？
At the count of three,
我们数到三的时候，
we're going to invite our senior pastor up, alright?
我们要邀请我们的主任牧师上台。
1, 2, 3, let's welcome him. Woo!
Hallelujah, praise God.
Hallelujah, 赞美主.
Today is such a wonderful day.
今天是非常美妙的一天.
Just now during the time of worship, it was just so amazing.
刚才在敬拜的时候呢, 觉得特别奇妙.
You know, if it's the first time we've ever been worship, if it's your first time worshiping in different languages at one service,
如果你第一次在一个聚会里面用两种语言来敬拜的话,
I'm going to tell you that that's a glimpse of what heaven's going to be like.
我要跟你讲，天堂是很多很多不同语言的。
Because it's across every tribe and every single tongue, every single language.
因为是不同的方言，不同的种族，不同的语言。
And really, this weekend, this today is so beautiful.
所以今天特别美好。
Before we started, I went upstairs to take a look at the children.
在我们开始之前呢，我就去了楼上看一看我们的居代儿童事工。
I see a lot of the children and the parents so happy to be back here.
爸爸妈妈们还有孩子们都特别高兴能够回来。
And as I came down, I started saying hi to some of you.
我下来的时候呢，就跟你们几个人说声打声招呼。
Say hi in English and say hi in broken Chinese.
用英文说你们好，用中文也说你们好。
But it's just so beautiful.
能够回来真好。
Well, let's jump into the Word of God.
好，我们进入神的话语。
I'm sure we're all excited.
相信大家都是特别的期待。
I know that all the Chinese congregation are definitely very happy.
中文聚会的朋友们，你们在吗？
Because you're,
Hallelujah.
Any of our Chinese congregation, are you over at Suntec?
有在新达城的华语聚会的弟兄姊妹有在那边吗？ 挥挥手。
Okay, I see some of your hands. So that's great.
欢迎你们。
You know. I know the Chinese congregation is definitely very happy.
我知道华语聚会的弟兄姊妹特别开心。
Because I'm not preaching through your lunchtime anymore.
因为我再也不会在你们12点吃饭的时间再正道了啊。
So I think we'll all be happy about that.
大家都开心。
Well, we've been going through a series of messages over the last couple of weeks.
我们在这几个星期下来呢，都一直在分享了同类似主题的信息。
At the start of June, it was the Pentecost weekend.
6月头的时候呢，就是五旬节的周末。
So since then, we've been talking a lot about the Holy Spirit.
然后呢，我们就一直提及讨论到圣灵。Talking
about the outpouring of His Spirit and revival.
我们说到圣灵的浇灌，圣灵充满，还有复兴。
Last weekend, Pastor Wei Long brought a great message.
上个星期，伟龙牧师给我们带来特别好的信息。It
was a message that he called "Growing in Anointing."
上个礼拜的信息主题叫做“恩膏的增长”。Now,
I just want to quickly talk to us about what is anointing.
跟大家赶紧的，我们来解释一下什么是恩膏。I
was thinking about it. I studied it, and I put down this simple definition.
我就思考了，然后就放下了这个非常简单的定义。
Anointing is the outpouring of God's favor or power upon a person.
恩膏呢，就是神向某一个人浇灌的恩惠或者是大能。
When you go to the Old Testament, you read a lot about how they anoint people are anointed with oil.
你知道，在旧约的时候呢，很多的子民都是用油被膏抹的。And
this anointing is poured over them.
而这个膏抹呢，是淋在从头上到脚底下的。When
we talk about the anointing of the Holy Spirit,
当我们说到圣灵的恩膏的时候，
it is the favor and power of God that is poured out upon us.
就是神的恩惠和大能呢，浇灌淋在你身上。So
when we say we want to grow in anointing,
所以当我们说我们要在恩膏里面增长，
we want to grow in our capacity to receive. God's power.
我们要在容量上更多的领受到神的恩惠跟大能。
So Pastor Wilong shared with us three important ways we can prepare ourselves to receive this.
所以伟龙牧师呢就跟我们分享了三个可以预备我们的方法。
He shared this.
他说
，How can we grow in anointing?
圣灵增长需要以下的三方面，哪三方面的成长呢
？Number one, we must grow in holiness.
第一，我们要有圣洁的生命。
The Bible always tells us the prayer of a righteous person is powerful and effective.
圣经教导我们，义人的祷告是大有能力的。
Number two, we must grow in intimacy.
第二呢，我们要与神的关系要亲近。
See, you and I have no power.
你跟我是没有能力的。
Power comes from God.
能力是来自于神。
Therefore, if we want to see and experience that power,
因此如果我们要看见，我们要经历到神的大能的话，
we need to be closer and closer to God.
我们要与神越来越亲近。
So we must grow in intimacy.
所以我们要与神更亲近。
And finally,
最后呢？
To grow in anointing, we must grow in reaching out.
在恩膏里面成长呢，我们要在对外的服事上，我们要成长。
When we do the task that God has called us to do,
当神差我们去做他要我们做的事，我们去做。
Then it's actually when we see the anointing growing.
我们就会看见我们的恩膏，神的恩膏会增长。
See, if we're not doing the things we're supposed to do,
如果神叫我们去做的，我们并没有去做
，then this anointing is pointless.
然后这个恩膏就废掉了，没力了。
What's the point of God pouring out His power on us?
神浇灌，
if we don't use that power?
神浇灌他的大能在你身上，可是你又不使用它，又有什么用呢
？So these are three important things.
所以这是非常重要的三方面。
I want to carry on this thought.
我要延续上个星期的信息。
And we're going to look at the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 12.
然后我们就要一起看哥林多前书第十二章。
We're reading verses 4 to 11.
我们一起来看第四节到第十一节。
I'll read in English first, and then Paul will read the Mandarin.
我会先用英语来读，然后保罗会用中文来读。
There are different kinds of gifts, but the same Spirit distributes them. There are different kinds of service, but the same Lord. There are different kinds of working, but in all of them and in everyone, it is the same God at work. Now to each one, the manifestation of the Spirit is given for the common good. To one, there is given through the Spirit a message of wisdom. To another, a message of knowledge by means of the same Spirit. To another, faith by the same Spirit.To another, gifts of healing by that one Spirit. To another, miraculous powers. To another, prophecy. To another, distinguishing between spirits. To another, speaking in different kinds of tongues. And still to another one, the interpretation of these tongues. All these are the work of one and the same Spirit, and He distributes them to each one just as He determines.
哥林多前书第十二章第四节到第十一节。恩赐原有分别，圣灵却是一位；执事也有分别，主却是一位；功用也有分别，神却是一位。在众人里面运行一切的事，圣灵显在个人身上，是叫人得益处。这人蒙圣灵赐他智慧的言语，那人也蒙这位圣灵赐他所知识的言语；又有一人蒙这位圣灵赐他信心，还有一人蒙这位圣灵赐他医病的恩赐；又叫一人能行异能，又叫一人能做先知，又叫一人能辨别诸灵，又叫一人能说方言，又叫一人能翻方言。这一切都是这位圣灵所运行，随己意分给个人的。
Let us pray.
我们一起祷告。
Lord, we thank you for your word.
主啊，感谢你赐给我们你的话语。
And we ask that as we hear your message today,
求你当我们在聆听你的话语的时候，
speak to us and transform us.
跟我们说话，转化我们。
As we hear your word in two different languages,
当我们用两种不同语言来聆听你的话语的时候，
give us a double portion, God.
赐给我们双倍的得着。
Cause us to walk in your spirit.
使我们在你的灵里面与你同行。
And to grow in your anointing.
而在你的恩膏里面增长。
We thank you.
感谢你主。
In Jesus' name we pray.
用耶稣的名祷告。
Amen.
Amen.
The message I have for us this weekend is called Spiritual Gifts.
这个周末的信息主题叫做属灵恩赐。
And it's very relevant to continue on from last week's message.
而我觉得是延续上个星期的信息特别贴切。
Just a very quick recap again what anointing is.
让我重复一下恩膏的定义。
Anointing, like I said, is the outpouring of God's favor or power upon a person.
正如我所说的，恩膏就是神向某个人浇灌的恩惠或者大能。
So what then is the difference between anointing and spiritual gifts?
那恩膏还有属灵恩赐有什么不一样呢？
Well, spiritual gifts is going one level deeper, I suppose.
属灵的恩赐呢，就是更深一个层次了。
Or at least it's something that's a little bit more specific.
又或者说是比较具体、更加清楚的。
See, anointing talks about God's power.
当我们说到恩膏，我们就说到神的大能。
But when we're talking about spiritual gifts, we're talking about very specific things.
当我们说到属灵恩赐的时候呢，我们就说到一个非常具体的一个恩赐。
For example, we looked at 1 Corinthians 12 just now.
打个比方说，刚才我们看了哥林多前书第十二章。
In this passage, there are 9 different spiritual gifts listed.
在刚才所读的经文里面呢，有九种不同的属灵恩赐。
So、just quickly take a look at them.
赶紧看一看吧。
We have firstly words of wisdom.
首先呢，我们在这个第八节有智慧言语。
And then we see that there are words of knowledge as well.
有知识的言语。
There is a gift of great faith.
然后有赐下伟大的信心。
This is the exceptional level of faith.
然后有这个超是一个超然的信心。
We talk about healing.
说到医病的恩赐
the gift of seeing miracles,
说到行异能的恩赐
you go further on, it talks about the gift of prophecy.
然后再接下来说到做先知的这个恩赐
the gift of discernment between spirits.
一个能够辨别诸灵的恩赐
the gift of speaking in tongues.
一个能够说方言的恩赐
and the gift of interpreting tongues.
还有一个能够翻译方言的一个恩赐
this list of course is not exhaustive.
这九个不是全部哈
there's a lot of spiritual gifts all throughout scripture.
其实在经文里面经文里面有许多的不同的属灵恩赐，可是呢，这只是其中九个。
But I want to show us here that these 9 things listed are very specific.
可是我要跟你说的就是，这九个被提及到的恩赐呢，是非常的具体的。
It's not just, it doesn't just say God's power.
它并没有只是概括的说是神的大能。
I talk specifically, healing, words of wisdom, speaking tongues, so on.
可是它一一的把它给列出来，比如说智慧啊、知识啊、信心的。
So as much as I show us this list, I don't want us to get caught up with it.
可是呢，我当我提到第九个这九个的时候呢，我不希望你开始就数，哎呀，我有几个这样子、啊。
Yeah, it's not about checking your own life. Why I got 1, 3, 5, and 6.
并不是说你自己生命里面啊，我有第一个，我有第四个，我有第八个这样子。
But actually, what I want to do today is help us better appreciate spiritual gifts.
可是我要帮助大家更加好的去欣赏到属灵的恩赐。
And I'd like to share with us 3 important truths to help us better appreciate spiritual gifts.
而我要帮助我们呢，能够更好的去欣赏属灵恩赐的三个真理。
So the first thing I want to share with us is this.
所以我想分享的第一个真理是什么呢
？Number one, spiritual gifts are gifts of grace.
第一呢，属灵的恩赐呢，其实就是恩典的礼物。
I suppose this might be quite obvious to us.
你可能会觉得这个太明显了吧
？Everything is a gift of grace.
其实什么都是神赐给的恩典嘛。
But let's talk about what a gift is.
可是让我们来定义一下什么是礼物。
A gift is something that is given willingly to someone without payment. It's a present.
礼物呢，就是自愿无偿的给予某人的东西，是一件礼物。
I'm sure all of us we've received gifts in our life before.
相信大家，尤其是圣诞节的时候，会收到很多礼物，对不对？
Now, when someone gives you a gift,
当有人送你一件礼物的时候
，Do you pay them for it?
你要拿钱出来赔偿他吗
？Of course not.
当然不需要了。
The moment you pay for it, it's not a gift anymore.
你拿钱出来赔偿他，这个就不是礼物了。
So similarly with spiritual gifts.
同样的，就是属灵的恩赐。
It's not some kind of thing that you buy.
并不是你以金钱可以买下来的东西。
I buy it with my holiness. I buy it with my years of being a Christian.
我用我的圣洁的程度来购买它。我用我多年服侍的经验来购买它。
I can earn it, I can gain it because I've gone to church every day of the last 5 years.
我是赚取回来的，因为我这五年来都是每一个星期都去教会的。
See, that's not how it works.
其实并不是这样子交换的。
Spiritual gifts are a gift.
属灵的恩赐就是恩典的礼物。
So 1 Corinthians 12:7 says this.
所以刚才我们看到哥林多前书第十二章第七节告诉我们。
Now to each one, the manifestation of the Spirit is given.
圣灵给个人不同的恩赐，为要使众人得益处。
It didn't say that the Spirit of God sells us this power.
并没有说圣灵便宜的卖给个人的恩赐。
No, it's given.
而这个经文讲的是给。
And this is an important concept for us to grasp.
这是我们必须拿捏好的一个很重要的一个概念。
This is so fundamental.
它是一个非常重要的一个基础知识。
Because for some reason, sometimes we think that, you know, we have to earn spiritual gifts.
因为很多时候我们会有一个误解，我们觉得我们必须努力的去赚取这个恩赐。
We feel like in our spiritual journey.
我觉得在我们的属灵的路程上
，You know, you got it's like you're playing a game.
就好像在玩某个游戏。
You know, you got to go through different levels, different stages.
你要经过不同难关。
You got to beat these stages.
你要打败这个大 boss.
Then you get more experience.
然后就有经历啦，
有
经验了。
Then you get a new power.
然后就有新的那个能力了。
After 2 years of being a Christian.
当了基督徒两年之后
，Wow, you gain the spirit of, you gain the gift of speaking in tongues.
哇，功力大增，你就可以讲方言啦。
Well, after 5 years,
或者五年之后
，Now you will earn the spirit of interpreting tongues.
你就是大师兄了，你就可以翻译方言了。
Wow, you want to cast out demons?
哇，你要赶鬼。
Then you need to be a Christian for 20 years.
那你要做到第20年才可以赶鬼，第19年赶不走。
Some people think that that's how it is.
有人的确是有这样的概念的。
That what you know, it's a you must level up. Then only by seniority, then we get spiritual gifts.
你要越来越有资历，才可以赶更厉害的鬼这样子。
But if that's the case, then this is not quite a gift, right?
这样的话就不是一个上帝给你的恩赐
了。If you have to earn it, then it's not really a gift.
如果你需要去赚取的话，那就不是礼物了。
And we need to understand this.
所以我们必须理解。
Because sometimes in the church, we kind of gauge people by what spiritual gift they have.
很多时候在教会呢，我们有这个误解，我们会因着每个人的属灵恩赐去衡量他有多圣洁。
Wow, you can speak in tongues.
哇，你会讲方言呐。
Wow, you must be very holy.
哇，你是大师兄，你很厉害。
That's how we think.
我们有这样的想法的。
But that's something that will jam us when it comes to spiritual gifts.
可是这样会导致我们无法前行的。
1 Corinthians 12:11.
哥林多前书第十二章第十一节。
All these are the work of one and the same Spirit, and He distributes them to each one just as He determines.
第十二章第十一节告诉我们，这一切都是这位圣灵所运行，随己意分给个人的。
God decides and determines how, who, what, when in terms of these spiritual gifts.
神呢会按着自己的意思要分给什么人，就会分给什么人。
He chooses it.
他会决定，他会选择。
That is what we must highlight in this verse. He determines this.
所以我们就标注了这个部分，讲是随己意分给个人的。
If you look at the word spiritual gift,
如果你看看属灵恩赐这个字。
It's very clear in Chinese.
中文呢说的是比较很清楚的。
Okay, bilingual service, we have a bit of a language lesson.
双语的我们就要学一学彼此的语言哈。
When actually, I know everyone knows I'm very English based one 啦。
很多人都知道我是讲英文比较厉害的。
Very 简单弯啦。
我很马铃薯的。
马铃薯对 ，Okay. But I read my Bible on my tablet.
我在我的平板电脑上，我会读我的圣经。
I always read 4 versions simultaneously.
我通常呢都会分别读四个不同版本的。
So on my laptop, you see these 4 columns there.
在我的平板电脑上就会看到有四个格子哈，有不同的经文的语言。
3 are in English and 1 is always Chinese.
三个版本是英语的，其中第四个版本一定是华语的。
I know when I speak Chinese is a bit.Weird one 啦，
我知道我讲华语的时候，有些人甚至可能会听不懂。
我讲中文的时候有点迟钝的啦。
迟钝啊。
But interestingly, I can actually read Chinese pretty well.
可是其实我中文读得不错的。
You give me a 早报, I can read most of it one.
你拿一份早报来给我读，我可以读得完的。
So I like reading a Chinese translation of scripture.
所以我很喜欢读中文版，因为可以看对照一下他们的翻译。
Because in the end, the English Bible is also a translation of the Greek or the Hebrew.
因为最终呢，其实英文版的圣经就是希腊文或者是希伯来文的翻译。
So if we are blessed to know multiple languages,
所以如果上帝祝福了你，让你读得懂不同语言的话
，reading different translations can give you certain unique perspectives.
你读了不同语言的版本呢，会给你一个不同的视角。
Remember, I talk about this word gift.
记得吗？刚才我说这个恩赐啊，礼物这个字。
The Greek word used in scripture for gift is the word called charismata.
希腊文呢，礼物这个字呢，是叫做 charismata.
And charismata means a free gift or a gift of grace.
Charismata 它的原文希腊文的意思就是一个免费的礼物，恩典的礼物。
If you're quite familiar with some of these Greek or Christian sayings, you will know that the word charis.Is the word grace?
如果你特别熟悉一些希腊文的用意呀，我们会知道，经常听到这个字叫做 charis， 它的意思就是恩典。
So the whole idea of spiritual gifts is that grace is so tightly connected to it.
所以呢，这整个概念就是属灵的恩赐其实就是神的恩典。
And that's why the Chinese one is so direct.
所以当我们说中文说属灵恩赐很清楚。
Got the word "earn" there, grace.
有一个恩字在里面。
So we must understand spiritual gifts is out of grace.
所以我们要知道属灵的恩赐的确是神的恩典。
But if you go back to last week's sermon,
可是如果你回到上个星期的这个信息。
Hey, but Pastor Wei Long said we must grow in holiness, grow in intimacy, must go and do things.
可是伟龙牧师上个礼拜不是说我们要跟神亲近，要努力的，我们要去服侍，我们要对外服侍嘛
？Pastor, I thought it's a gift.
牧师，我以为这个是个恩赐，一份礼物啊。
It is a gift.
的确是礼物。
But growing in holiness，
可是在我们的这个圣洁的增长
，growing in intimacy with God，
与神亲近的过程
，growing in reaching out，
我们对外的服事
，that prepares you to receive that gift。
这三项工作就会预备我们去领受神的恩赐。
So remember this，
所以要记住。
They are gifts of grace that He determines.
是由神随己意分给我们的属灵恩赐。
So truth number one.
所以第一个真理呢
？Spiritual gifts are gifts of grace.
就是属灵的恩赐是恩典的礼物。
Truth number two.
第二个真理
？Spiritual gifts are also tools for tasks.
属灵的恩赐也是让我们完成使命任务的工具。
Basically, these spiritual gifts are given to us so that we can fulfill certain tasks that God has for us.
神赐给我们属灵的恩赐是要我们完成他差给我们的任务。
1 Corinthians 12:7 again.
再一次的哥林多前书第十二章第七节。
Now to each one, the manifestation of the Spirit is given for the common good.
圣灵显在个人身上是叫人得益处。
It's so that people can be blessed, people can be saved, people can be transformed.
是好叫人可以被祝福，可以得救，可以得着上帝。
Basically, as Christians, it is a call to serve.
身为基督徒的我们呢，我们的呼召就是要去服事。
And all Christians, we have the Great Commission.
而所有的基督徒都知道，我们有这个东西叫做大使命。
Make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
使万民做我的门徒，奉父子圣灵，我们要让他们全部都施洗。
And in order to fulfill this commission,
而要完成这一份大使命呢
？God gives us spiritual gifts.
神就赐给我们这些属灵的恩赐。
Jesus himself demonstrates this.
耶稣也彰显给我们看见了。
He was equipped with spiritual gifts to do the work of God.
神也装备了他，给了他属灵的恩赐，来可以完成神的工作。
What did Jesus do?
他做了什么呢？
He preached the word of God.
他讲神的道。
He healed the sick.
他医病。
He cast out demons.
他赶鬼。
And how do you do all this?
他怎么做这些的呢？
Is it because he's Jesus? He's super talented.
是因为就因为他是耶稣，他超有才华，他就可以做到这一切吗？
No, he did all this because the Spirit of God empowered him.
他能够做这些，因为是神的灵高了他。
So at the beginning of his ministry, he said this in Luke 4:18-19.
所以在他刚开始他那个时间的事工的时候呢，路加福音就说了这段话。
The Spirit of the Lord is on me because He has anointed me to proclaim good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim freedom to the prisoners and recovery of sight for the blind, to set the oppressed free, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor.
路加福音第四章第十八节到第十九节，主的灵在我身上，因为他用膏我，叫我传福音给贫穷的人，差遣我报告被掳的得释放，瞎眼的得看见，叫那受压制的得自由。报告神约纳人的喜年。
There's a lot more we can read in that passage.
在那段经文里面有更多的。
But the key thing is that he is a call to action.
可是呢，你要知道的，这个就是呼召要我们去行动的。
It didn't just say that the Spirit of Sovereign Lord is on me, full stop.
他并没有说神的灵在我身上啊就好了。
It says the Spirit of God has anointed me.To do this, to do that, to proclaim freedom, to proclaim His gospel, and so on.
而经文告诉我们说，神的灵在我的身上，他用膏膏了我，叫我做那个，差遣我做那个，叫那受压的得自由。
Jesus understood that the gifts are tools for tasks.
耶稣他完完全全理解到这些属灵的恩赐呢，就是任务的工具。
Now, church, do we understand this?
可是教会，我们理解吗？
Because sometimes we as Christians we don't understand this.
因为很多时候我们是基督徒，可是我们不理解。
We end up somehow thinking at times that spiritual gifts become medals of honor or badges of merit.
可是很多时候呢，我们就会有个错误的概念，觉得属灵的恩赐呢就是荣誉的宣章，就是可以，就是说我们做的特别卓越的意思。
There's a very famous evangelist by the name of Reinhard Bonnke.
有一个非常有名的布道家，他的名就是他姓布也是的，他叫布永康。
He passed on recently, and we had the honor of having him at our 2019 conference.
他最近去世了，可是2019年在我们的大会里面呢，他来讲道过。
But I remember really listening to an old message of his.
我记得当时他有讲过一篇很久以前讲过一篇道。
Now he always talks a lot about the spiritual gifts.
他经常会讨论到讲关于属灵恩赐的道。
If you've heard him and seen him before, he brings about a lot of healing, supernatural healing.
如果你见过他或者听过他证道，他会带来很多医治的。
And he said he always observed this trend in the church.
然后他就在教会呢，就发现到有这样的一个趋势。
Where people start comparing spiritual gifts.
当很多人开始比较属灵恩赐这个东西。
How many gifts you have?
你有几个属灵恩赐啊?
Oh, you got more, that's why you're the cell leader.
你有多一点啊? 哎呀, 难怪你是组长啦,
oh, so you look at the pastor.
有人看的牧师,
wow, so gifted, can do so many things.
哇, 好有才啊, 可以做那么多事情。
That's why this is the pastor.
所以他才是牧师吗?
But the, when people say that, we have a wrong understanding
of spiritual gifts. 可是当你这么说的时候, 我们其实对这个属灵恩赐有一个错误的概念了。
With this idea that, wow, gifts are only meant for senior people or whatever.
我们一向都觉得这个属灵恩赐呢, 只是让那些比较资深的人才有的。
We think that, oh, seniority or you got, you deserve this, then you have this spiritual gift.
我们就觉得, 哎, 你在教会很久了, 你有资历了, 你就更多属灵恩赐。
Or some people think that it's meant to show off.
人家以为是拿来炫耀的。
You know, I can do this, I can do that.
我可以做这个, 我可以医病, 我可以赶鬼。
I've heard Christians, I've heard people in our own church say that before.
我知道在我们教会有人这样子说的。
Other times, there are people who find that spiritual gifts are like toys to play with.
很多时候呢, 甚至有人会觉得属灵的恩赐好像是, 玩具。
It's like, it's a nice thing, right?
是一个很好的一个用途啊。
You have seen people jump from miracle service to miracle service to miracle service.
你会看见很多人去参加不同教会的那些神迹的聚会。
Because it's like a very, very, very just an interesting thing to look at.
因为就觉得去那边特别有意思, 看人家医病啊, 赶鬼啊, 哇, 特别有意思啊。
凑热闹的 kind of thing.
啊, 去凑凑一下热闹。
You know, go and just be part of it.
就去参加嘛, 就很热闹。
But I need to teach us this important thing.
可是我们必须教导这个很重要的真理。
Spiritual gifts are neither toys to be played with, nor trophies to be shown off. They are tools for service.
属灵恩赐既不是用来玩的玩具, 也不是用来炫耀的奖杯, 属灵的恩赐是服侍人的工具。
That is why we have these spiritual gifts.
所以我们才会有这些属灵恩赐。
So don't ever show off just because you think you can do a lot of things.
所以不要觉得你有很多属灵恩赐就拿来炫耀。
Don't think less of yourself just because you feel like you are not as gifted as somebody else.
也不要觉得因为你没有什么, 就是或者你没有别人那么有才, 你就觉得很自卑。
See, when we do the work that God has called us to do,
当我们去做神召我们去做的事情的时候,
the Holy Spirit passes us a toolbox.
圣灵就会赐给我们一个工具箱。
And as we serve, there are different tools in this toolbox.
在我们服侍的时候呢, 工具箱里面有很多不同的工具可以拿来用的。
So in 1 Corinthians 12, 4 to 6.
所以呢, 在哥林多前书第12章第4节到第6节,
there are different kinds of gifts, but the same Spirit distributes them. There are different kinds of service, but the same Lord. There are different kinds of working, but in all of them and everyone, it is the same God at work.
恩赐原有分别, 圣灵却是一位, 执事也有分别, 主却是一位, 功用也有分别, 神却是一位, 在众人里面运行一切的事。
See, there are many different tools.
有很多工具的。
And as Christians, we should be well-versed in as many tools as possible.
我们要熟用所有的工具。
For somehow, another misconception we have in the church,
我们在教会有另外一个错误的概念,
is that we have this idea,
就是我们有这个概念,
that there will always be one spiritual gift to rule them all.
就是一定会有一样工具是掌管一切的,
最高境界的,
指环王 Lord of the Rings.
It's the only thing that you want to go for.
就有如就是那个, 你拿到了那个你就最厉害的了。
And it's like, wow, you know, I must have the gift of interpreting tongues. I must have the gift of casting out demons.
我一定要有那个能够翻译方言, 能够赶鬼的那个才是最厉害的功力啊。
If you truly want to serve God,
如果你真真实实要服侍主的话,
we need all the tools.
我们是需要所有的工具的。
Since we're using this analogy of a tool,
既然我们用到说用工具的这个, 比喻,
if you ever call a handyman or repairman to your house,
如果你有, 找到一个修理师傅来到你家帮你修理东西,
they open up their toolbox.
他们去打开工具箱。
Got a lot of tools on, right?
里面有很多不同的工具。
Nobody uses just one tool.
没有人只是用一个 spanner 就可以把所有东西都修好。
Okay, a hammer can do one thing.
一个锤子是可以做一个功能。
But a hammer can hammer a nail in.
一个, 锤子可以把钉子给钉进去。
A hammer cannot screw a screw in.
可是它不可以把, 那个钉子给转进去的。
So it's different.
所以是不一样的。
And so we cannot think that, oh, you know, I only need one spiritual gift ever.
你不能觉得, 啊, 我这一辈子只需要一个特别好用的一个属灵恩赐就好了。
Just like a handyman won't say, I only need one tool ever.
就好像是一个修理师傅, 他在做一切的杂物的时候, 他不会说我只需要一个工具。
Now I know some people may say, hey, but pastor, now got these things like Swiss Army knife, right?
可是你会觉得, 牧师, 我现在有一个万能的瑞士军刀。
You know those things you can pull all kind, everything one?
你打开来有 18把刀这样子。
Last night I said this and people were saying that, yeah, pastor, but got Swiss Army knife, what?
有人, 昨天晚上正道的时候, 有人说, 对啊, 牧师这个瑞士军刀有很多功能啊。
It's true, there are Swiss Army knives, there are multi-tools.
是真的, 是18合一的, 对。
But I ask you a question.
可是我要问你一个问题。
Will you renovate your house using a Swiss Army knife?
你会用一把小小的瑞士军刀去装修你整个家吗？
不可能啊， it doesn't work.
不可能的。
That's not how it works. It's not,
不是这个样子的，
no way we can do
it. 并不可能这样做的。
We need all the different tools for different moments.
我们需要在不同的时刻用上不同的工具来执行神的任务。
In fact, I'll go one step further. You know?
我还会再讲深入的探讨一下。
My dad likes to say this.
我的父亲喜欢说。
When you move in the gifts of the Holy Spirit.
当你按着圣灵的恩赐运行的时候。
It's like you have a toolbox.
就好像你有工具箱了。
So someone got a demon in them.
有人呢身体上附鬼了。
Picture yourself bringing this spiritual toolbox.
我就拿这个属灵的工具箱。
But you open up this toolbox, right?
打开工具箱。
Actually, it's empty, you know.
里面是空的。
Because it is whatever the Holy Spirit imparts upon you in that moment.
因为是当时在当下圣灵赐给你的工具就拿用
了。He will give you the, he'll equip you with the necessary tools you need for that particular moment.
他会及时装备你来做你所要做的。
See, if that's not the case, then we all get trapped in this wrong thinking.
如果不是这样子的话，我们就会有一个错误的概念了。
That everybody only got one particular gift.
就会认为每个人就只有一种特殊的属灵恩赐。
That Christians are one trick ponies.
基督徒呢，就是好像只会一招一招闯天下了。
Okay, we only know how to do that one thing.
我们只会天残脚。
That's not quite correct, you know.
这不是正确的。
Then how to serve?
那怎么服侍呢
？Like that, then the church becomes can become very clinical, you know.
那教会就会变得特别单一，做事就没有情感。
If you need ministry, you come to our office lah.
你需要服侍的话，你就来我的办公室吧。
Take a number.
拿个号码。
Okay, see what's wrong with you?
那你有什么病啊
？Or demon possession 啊？
哦，附鬼了哈。
Okay, go to room 4, Pastor Jenny Ong over there.
四号房啊 ，Jenny Ong 牧师在那边等你很久了哈。去那边。
Okay, what's wrong?
Next one, 不舒服啊。
What's wrong with you?
有什么事
？Or need healing 啊？
需要医治哈。
Sore throat 啊。
喉咙痛哈。
Eat too much durian 啊。
吃太多榴莲哈。
Room one, Pastor Wei Long is there.
伟龙牧师啦，吃榴莲找他。
That's not how ministry is, right?
不是这样的。
All of us should be able to minister.
我们每一个人都是可以被神使用来去服侍的。
We all have this same toolbox from the Holy Spirit.
圣灵赐给的那工具箱是一样的，都可以用的。
And we can serve in that same way.
而我们可以同样的去服侍。
Remember last week, Pastor Willong brought this thing up.
记得上个星期伟龙牧师说过这句话。
He shared part of this passage, John chapter 14, verses 12 to 14.
他就是在约翰福音第十四章第十二节到第十四节。
Jesus said this, Very truly I tell you, whoever believes in me will do the works I have been doing. And they will do even greater things than these, because I am going to the Father. And I will do whatever you ask in my name, so that the Father may be glorified in the Son. You may ask me for anything in my name, and I will do it.
约翰福音第十四章第十二节到第十四节，我实实在在的告诉你们，我所做的事，信我的人也要做，并且要做比这个更大的事，因为我往父那里去。你们奉我的名，无论求什么，我必成就，叫父因儿子得荣耀。你们若奉我的名求告什么，我必成就。
Whatever Jesus did, we will do greater things.
耶稣所做的，我们会做更大的事。
He preached, he cast out demons, he healed the sick.
他讲道，他医病，他赶鬼。
He raised the dead.
他使死人复活。
We should be doing greater things than this.
我们应该做的比这更大的事。
I know we hear this, you say, huh, how can?
我们通常听到这段话，我们就觉得，哈，不可能。
How can I do things that are greater than Jesus?
我怎么能做比耶稣更伟大的事呢？
The answer is actually in John 14 as well.
答案也在这个约翰福音第十四章。
Let's look at verses 15 to 18.
我们看一下第十五节到第十八节。
If you love me, keep my commands, and I will ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to help you and be with you forever. He is the Spirit of truth. The world cannot accept him because it neither sees him nor knows him, but you know him, for he lives with you, he will be in you, and I will not leave you as orphans, I will come to you.
约翰福音第十四章第十五节到第十八节，你们若爱我，就必遵守我的命令。我要求父，父就另外赐给你们一位保惠师，叫他永远与你们同在，就是真理的圣灵，乃世人不能接受的，因为不见他，也不认识他，你们却认识他，因他常与你们同在，也要在你们里面。我不撇下你们为孤儿，我必到你们这里来。
So today Jesus says this to us.
所以今天耶稣告诉我们，
You can do greater things than him.
你可以做比他更伟大的事。
You will say how?
你会问怎么做？
Jesus has an answer for you.
耶稣就是答案。
I have sent you the Spirit of God.
他告诉你我已经
God will send you the Spirit.
神会差你一个保惠师。
He lives with you, he is in you, and you will not be alone.
他常与你同在，他在你里面。
He will give you the tools for the task He's called you to do.
他会赐给你所需要做的任务所需要的工具。
Church, today don't think for a moment that moving in the spiritual is not for you.
教会千万不要觉得按着圣灵里面运行是不符合你的。
It is just for the spiritual people.
只是符合那些特别属灵的人。
Just for the pastors, for the leaders.
牧师跟组长可以做了，我不可以。
No, it's for all of us.
是给每一个人的。
Because all of us are called.
因为每个人都是蒙神呼召要去服侍的。
So that's the second thing.
所以这是第二了。
Let's take a quick recap.
我们来回顾一下。
Number one.
第一
spiritual gifts are gifts of grace.
属灵的恩赐是恩典的礼物。
Number two,
第二
spiritual gifts are tools for tasks.
属灵的恩赐是任务的工具。
And finally, number three,
最后第三
spiritual gifts are disciplines to be developed.
属灵的恩赐是纪律的培养。
What this means is that we must put this into practice.
我们必须学以致用。
Sometimes we have this idea that when a spiritual gift is imparted upon us,
有时候我们觉得属灵恩赐被赐给我们的时候
you know, we say Holy Spirit empower us, Holy Spirit fill us.
我们就会说圣灵啊，求你赐我大能，求你充满我。
We feel like, wow, when that happens, it means that, wow, like I cannot possess by the Holy Spirit.
那我们就觉得当神充满的时候，我们就会好像被圣灵附身了。
And then, you know, that, wow, I cannot control.
然后就哇，控制我，控制我，走前面。
Holy Spirit empower me to preach the gospel.
我们就说圣灵啊，求你赐我大能，能够讲福音。
Wow, the Holy Spirit fills you.
圣灵就充满你。
He move your left leg, he move your right leg, he everything control you.
然后他就控制你左脚，控制你右脚往前走。
Hey, the fruit of the spirit is called self-control. You know.
你知道吗？圣灵的果子其中一个叫自律。
We have to take that ownership on our part.
我们必须也要把它当成是自己该做的事情。
Remember the other week when Pastor Kong preached?
记得之前有一个星期是老矿老矿老
矿
牧师
大矿啊，
不大老矿牧师他跟我们讲的，这是小矿嘛这个。
Remember he was talking about speaking in tongues.
你知道吗？他教导我们就是说到讲方言。
And since I was young until now, he always say the same thing when he teaching people how to speak in tongues.
从我小到现在，他都是教同样的功课的。
And some of you heard him say that week.
你们那个周末也听到他说这句话。
He said, "Hey, when you're speaking in tongues,
他说，当你们讲方言的时候
，It is not that the Holy Spirit grab your tongue and go,
圣灵并不是抓住你舌头，然后
He says, "No, you got to speak, you got to exercise that faith."
他说，你要踏出那第一步，你要讲。
Every spiritual gift is a discipline that you got to develop. You got to take the step of faith to do it.
每一个属灵的恩赐呢，你都要培养，你都要踏出那一步，你必须去使它成为更好的。
But many of us think that it's automated.
可是很多人都以为这个是自动化的。
Why?
为什么呢
？Because we have the wrong understanding of the word gift.
因为我们对礼物这个字有一个错误的想法。
What in Chinese, Jason?
礼物。
可以啊。
对啊，礼物。
Okay. Just now, I gave a definition of gift. That gift is something willingly given to somebody.
刚才呢，我们就做了定义。我们说这个礼物啊，是自愿无偿的给某一个人的礼物。
But we mistake it for another aspect of the word gift.
可是呢，很多时候礼物呢，我们把它当成有另外一种错误的定义。
Because another definition, at least in English, gift is a natural ability or talent.
神所赐的礼物有另外一个定义，我们认为是天生的能力或者是才能啊。
So you say someone is very gifted.
所以你说这个人啊，很有才。
Both are correct, but this is the wrong context.
两个都是对的，可是在这个用途上是错误的。
Spiritual gift is a gift of grace from the Lord.
属灵的恩赐在这个定义上就是一份神赐给的礼物。
It is not some talent.
并不是一个天生带来的才华或才能。
It is not just talented people that get the spiritual gifts.
并不是自然有才的人才会得着这些属灵恩赐的。
1 Corinthians 12:7 says this.
哥林多前书第十二章第七节告诉我们。
Now to each one, the manifestation of the Spirit is given for the common good.
圣灵显在个人身上是叫人得益处。
When he says each one, he's talking about everyone, all of us.
当他说个人的时候，是每个人。
The question is not whether God can empower you or whether He will empower you.
问题不在于神愿不愿意加添能力给你，或者是他会不会加添能力给你。
The question is whether we want it.
问题在于我们要不要。
Whether we will develop it.
问题在于我们会不会去培养它、培育它。
Church, all of us should take that faith and desire spiritual gifts.
教会，我们每个人都应该踏出信心的一步，去培育我们所被神所赐给我们的恩赐。
Paul wrote this in 1 Corinthians 14.
使徒保罗在哥林多前书第十四章第一节说。
Verse 1, he says, follow the way of love and eagerly desire gifts of the Spirit.
你们要追求爱，也要切慕属灵的恩赐。 其中要羡慕要是先知讲道。
And at the end of verse 39, at the end of that passage, verse 39, he says, "Therefore, my brothers and sisters, be eager to prophesy and do not forbid the speaking."
然后在整章十四章的尾端第三十九节，他说：“所以我弟兄们，你们要切莫做先知讲道，也不要禁止说方言。”
We must be eager for spiritual gifts.
我们要切莫得着神的属灵恩赐。
And we must continue to practice them.
而我们要经常的去练习。
2 weeks ago, when my dad was preaching and leading people to speak in tongues,
2个星期前呢，我的父亲讲到，他带领大家讲方言。
He actually gave us homework.
他其实给了我们功课。
He said, "Now that you know how to speak in tongues,"
他说，现在你们都会讲方言了。
You must go back and practice.
你们要回去练习。
You must go back and develop this new discipline.
要操练，因为这是新的一个纪律。
And I was in church that weekend.
那周末我在教会。
I saw many people. I prayed for people, and they spoke in tongues for the first time.
我为人祷告，他们就第一次讲方言。
But the question now is whether you have practiced it.
问题是你过后有没有去练习呢？操练呢？
Even for us as Christians, maybe you've spoken tongues for a long time already, but have you been practicing that?
甚至我们可能已经也会讲方言很多年了，可是你有去练习，你有去操练吗？
See, it is a discipline that must be developed.
这是一个必须培育跟培养的一个纪律。
Yes, I know at the end of the day, it's true when something happens, we will go to a pastor or cell leader.
最终我们知道，当我们有麻烦了，我们会去找牧师，会去找组长。
Hey, pray for us, help us in this situation.
为我祷告，你可以辅导我一下，怎么办？
The reason we go to them is not because they are very talented or gifted.
我们会去找这些组长或者是牧师，并不是因为他们比较有才能。
But the reason you do it is because they have actually developed these disciplines.
而是因为他们已经培养好这些属灵纪律了。
It is something that you got to practice, and as the more you do it, the better you get.
你越是操练，你就越会熟练。
When you minister to people,
当你去服侍别人的时候，
all the cell leaders here,
在座所有的组长们，
I'm sure you prayed for people before, you ministered to people before.
相信你有服侍过你的组员，你也为他们祷告。
The first time you pray for somebody,
你第一次为一个人祷告的时候，
it's very scary, right?
很可怕，对不对？
You scared, wow, do I what to say?
哎呀，该讲什么？
I don't have all the right words.
我不知道该讲对不对的话语。
What if I pray and nothing happens?
我祷告，然后他没有被医治，怎么办？
We have all this kind of fear.
你有很多惧怕。
I had that same kind of fear.
我曾经也有这样的惧怕。
That's why when I became a pastor,
所以当我成为牧师的时候，
every time after service when people are being prayed for,
每次聚会结束，有人来前面领受祷告。
I struggle to pray for people.
我有很大的挣扎为着别人祷告。
So I give myself a very sacred duty.
所以我给了我自己一个很神圣的任务。
Hold a tissue box for people.
就帮人家拿 tissue， 拿纸巾。
Because usually when I'm holding a tissue box there, right?
因为通常我拿着纸巾盒的时候，
people look at me, they somehow won't expect me to pray for them.
他们看到我就知道他们不会找我祷告的。
And when I'm holding the tissue box,
我拿着纸巾盒的时候，
I can look very busy one.
我可以看起来特别忙碌的。
Somebody down there, no one praying for him.
没有人为他祷告吗？
He look at me.
他看着我。
Then I straight, oh,
我就， 那边有人要 tissue。
Hey, the tissue very sacred duty, okay?
那个纸巾盒的任务很神圣的。
You see before people in altar, no?
你看过有人在前面在服侍的时候吗？
Well, pray and then cry and cry.
祷告啊，哭泣啊。
All the snot also coming out.
然后该出来的都出来了。
Down there, you're crying so badly.
然后哭得很惨。
Suddenly, you feel a gentle spirit put on tissue in your hand.
然后突然间很温柔的灵将纸巾放到你手上。
That's me.
就是我啦。 很重要，对不对？
Until one service,
直到在某一个聚会，
we were at Expo at that time still.
我们当时在博览中心。
Oh, my dad preaching, and it was, God was doing something amazing in
the
service.
我的父亲在讲到，当时神呢，圣灵大大充满。
And the altar was packed at Expo with people.
然后前台这边都满了，每个人都跑到前面来领受祷告。
Then I walk around my tissue box.
那我拿着纸巾盒了，照样的。
Tissue.
哎呀，别哭了，没事的啊。
Give out all the tissue.
然后就派纸巾。
But then there are so many people, even all the leaders, all the pastors, they're not, they cannot pray for everybody there.
可是很多人在前面，所有的牧者，所有的组长都在为人家祷告了，不够人，轮到我了。
So they told me like, put the tissue box down, go and pray for people.
他们终于对着我说，他忍无可忍的放下纸巾盒，为别人祷告吧。
笑了啊！我就疯了。So I go walk around.
所以我就走走走走。
Okay, and sometimes leaders we do this.
然后有时候组长我们是这样子的。
Leaders, we all know the tricks, right?
我们都知道那个 pattern 的啦.
You go there, we walk around, right?
走来走去, 然后呢?
You target who you want to pray for.
你看你要找你要为他祷告的什么人?
You think, well, this one looks should be quite simple, one.
啊，这个人祷告应该很简单, 他看起来还没有哭, okay 的, 啊,
you look, don't look for those, wow, if you see those cry like mad one, wow, okay.
你看到那些哭到很惨的, 你看到哭到很惨的, 你不要去为他祷告, 你跑远点啊。
So I walk around.
所以我就看,
I really very scared to pray for people.
然后帮人祷告, 哎, 我真的很紧张, 哈。
Hey, I saw people I know.
哎，有认识的。
Should be quite easy one.
容易啦，帮你祷告。
Okay, then I thought probably pray for work, you know, very generic prayer.
然后我觉得做一个大概的祷告啦，祝福他工作吧。
Bless my work, bless my family, bless my
祝福你的工作， okay. 祝福你的家庭。
Okay, can one, I can do it.
一定可以的，很简单的，就祷告好了。
So go there, pray for this couple that I know.
然后我就走到那边，然后帮一对夫妻祷告。
A bit 哑哑啦。
然后我就哎，很嚣张的。
Okay, I come. Hey, pray for you. How can I pray for you?
我能怎么样为你祷告?
We cannot conceive children. Can you pray that we will have a child?
我们, 生不到孩子, 你可以为我们祷告, 我们要生孩子吗? 纸巾盒在哪里?
What, like, 笑了啊, right?
那时我就觉得, 哎呀,
First one, what?
哇, 第一次为别人祷告就是生孩子啊。
And that's why we're always scared to pray for healing.
所以我们很怕帮人家医, 祷告医治,
and I did the biggest mistake.
而我就做了最大的一个错误。
Sometimes when we pray,
有时候我们为别人祷告,
we pray in a way to manage our own lack of faith.
我们祷告呢, 我们是为了安慰我们自己缺乏的信心。
So what do you say?
我们怎么说呢?
You pray for, okay, yeah, God, we know you heal. God, we know you can give life and everything.
我们就祷告说, 哎呀, 主啊, 我知道你会医治, 你赐生命的主。
But,
可是主,
even if you don't do it,
就算你不医治,
may they have peace, may they know that you are with them.
愿他有平安, 愿他知道你与他同在,
may they have the assurance of their salvation, 愿他们, of their souls.
愿他们有救赎的那个安稳,
I know you are a miracle working God.
我知道你是行神迹的神,
but even if it doesn't happen today,
可是就算今天没有医治,
没事的,
没关系,
it's okay one, no problem.
Okay的, 没问题的。
Then after that, my friend was praying for, got upset at me lah.
然后我在帮那个朋友祷告, 他就生气了。
I mean, you come forward for prayer, what kind of prayer is this?
你来到前面领受祷告, 你这是什么祷告啊, 牧师?
You know, when you pray for somebody and that person wonders, do you just pray for me or do you just curse me?
当你为一个人祷告, 然后那个接受祷告的人觉得你是在祝福我还是在诅咒我啊?
I think something wrong with our faith if that happens, you know?
如果是这样的话, 我们的信心的那个, 有问题了。
Anyway, long story short, the Lord brought me to the
face. 长话说短, 然后神就, 教导了我。
The Lord finally gave me a word and I released it to the couple.
他就赐给了我, 他就赐给我话语, 然后我就祝福了那对夫妻。
And I was a big struggle because I said, wow, I'm very Pisces. How do I release a word that say you're going to have a child?
很大的挣扎, 我怎么样释放话语说你会有孩子?
But I did it.
可是我做了。
And then, After prayer, later on, they had a child.
祷告完之后, 数月后, 他们真的怀孕了。
And after that, God gave me the challenge.
然后神就赐给了我这个挑战。
And God said, anytime anybody asks you to pray for something miraculous,
他说, 任何时候有人要求你祷告一个奇迹,
just do it.
就去做。
So, I trust God and obey.
所以我信靠我就顺服。
During that time, I shared this testimony at one church service years ago.
在教会的一个聚会呢，几年很多年前，我有讲过一次。
And after that service,
那个聚会之后呢，
a few couples stayed back to look for me.
有几对夫妇就留下来等我了。
They said they cannot conceive.
他们说他们 尝试了很久还没有孩子。
Ask me to pray.
就说为我祷告好吗？
One year I went to the G12 conference in Korea.
有一年呢，我去到韩国的 G12大会，
I shared this testimony.
我就分享了这个见证。
After the session ended, there was a queue of couples waiting for me.
结束了之后呢， 排长龙， 好像买榴莲这样。
I shared this testimony when I went to the Philippines to preach.
我去到菲律宾， 我也分享了这个见证。
One of the pastors came to find me after that.
其中一个牧师后来找我了。
As of now, if I recall correctly,
如果我没有记错的话，
there are about between 10 to 15 couples who couldn't conceive, now they've conceived after I prayed for them.
当时有10到15对无法生育的， 现在都生育了。
Glory belongs to God.
荣耀归给主,
I am not some birthing guru. Okay?
我并不是那种, 哇, 很会待产的那种, 不是,
okay,
不是。
Please, this is church, okay? We
这个是教会啊,
worship God, okay?
我们敬拜的是上帝啊。
Don't come try and touch my coat,
不要来,
try and rub my head or something.
不要来摸我的头发, 以为就会怀孕啊, 不要扒我的衣服啊。
But I remember when I first started.
可是我记得我刚开始的时候。
I was just very scared to pray.
我非常害怕为别人祷告。
When the first couple say, "Oh, couple ask me to pray for them this area," I'm very scared.
当第一对夫妻来叫我为他们祷告的时候，我非常害怕。
I actually started a lot.
我其实讲话战战兢兢的。
Go, pray.
我说上帝啊。
哇，跟很超上帝，
很 high level.
I was very, very scared, you know.
我特别害怕。
But I just kept doing it.
可是我就一直去做。
Again and again and again.
继续的去操练。
A couple of months ago, I prayed for a couple in our church who couldn't conceive.
两个月前呢，我为了一对夫妻也是做这样的祷告啊，祝福他们能生孩子。
My prayer not very long, not very sophisticated.
现在我的祷告是简短的，很简单。
I prayed for them in a very simple way.
我就很简单的为他们做祷告。
I spent some time praying in tongues with them.
陪他们我们一起来讲方言。
And I say, Lord,
说主啊。
Your word has said that the thief comes to kill and steal and destroy.
你的话语说呢，盗贼来就是为了要偷窃、要破坏、要毁灭。
But you have come to give life and life to the full.
可是主，你要赐的是生命，而且是丰盛的生命。
We claim this life in the name of Jesus. We speak life into this couple.
我们领受你的话语，我们赐生命给这对夫妻。
Amen.
Amen.
That's all I do.
搞定。
Because it's not me, what?
因为不是我。
Is that God hears that prayer?
成就一切的是聆听这祷告的上帝。
Last night, someone came up to me, asked me to pray for a tumor. I just prayed, God, heal, let the tumor be gone.
上个星期，昨天晚上讲完道，有一个人走过来说，牧师，我有一个瘤在我身体里面，为我祷告，我就祷告上帝，求你除去这个瘤。
10 years ago, me would not have said that, you know.
十年前的我就不敢这么祷告。
10 years ago, me would have gone to find the tissue box.
十年前的我会找纸巾盒。
To wipe my own tears because I cried.
来擦掉我自己的眼泪。
But that's the point I'm getting.
可是我想说的就是这个。
Just now I talked about Reinhard Bonnke.
刚才我说了布永康。
He's known for praying for healing and people see miraculous healing.
他出了名的，他就是讲这个医治的道，很多人来到他的大会都得医治。
If you've heard him share before.
如果你听他分享过。
He says there are moments that he can pray for 100 people, right?
他有试过为这一百个人祷告。
And only one person gets healed.
而只有一人得医治。
And you know what he says is the hundredth person that gets healed.
而且是在第一百个人的时候才得到医治。
Means you have to go through that 99 failure, you know.
也就是祷告99都没有医治，第一百才有医治。
But he just perseveres.
可是他坚持。
He just keeps on going on.
他继续这么做。
And he keeps developing this discipline.
他一直培养着他这个为人祷告的这个纪律。
And today we know Reinhard Bonnke as a healing evangelist.
今天我们知道布永康是一个带医治大能的这个宣教士。
And we know him as that because he persevered.
我们知道他鼎鼎有名，因为他坚持。
And because he developed this discipline.
而是因为他花很多时间去操练。
So 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 6 to 7 says this.
所以这个提摩太后书第一章第六节到第七节告诉我们。
For this reason, I remind you to fan into flame the gift of God, which is in you through the laying on of my hands. For the Spirit God gave us does not make us timid, but gives us power, love, and self-discipline.
为此我提醒你，使你将神借我按手所给你的恩赐再如火眺望起来，因为神赐给我们的不是胆怯的心，乃是刚强、仁爱、谨守的心。
Fan these spiritual gifts into flame.
挑旺这些属灵恩赐，让它火起来。
Practice them.
去操练。
You want to develop the gift of healing?
你要操练培育到这个能够医治的这个属灵恩赐吗
？Pray for people to be healed.
就开始为人祷告。
It is not suddenly wow, just download zoom, wow, then you can do it.
不是突然间好像按个钮然后下载然后就可以做了。
It's gonna keep practicing.
要继续的操练。
Some of us who received the gift of tongues 2 weeks ago.
两个星期前，在老邝牧师讲的道的时候，我们领受了讲方言。
You feel like it's gone.
你觉得现在好像又不太会讲了，不讲不能讲了。
But you practice it.
你要去操练。
Develop this.
你要去培养它，你要把它变得作为你生活的日常。
So today these are the three things I want to share.
所以今天呢，要分享的就是这三个真理了。
What are spiritual gifts?
属灵恩赐是什么呢
？Number one.
第一
，They are gifts of grace.
是恩典的礼物。
We can't earn them.
我们不可以去赚取的。
God gives them to us.
只是神随他的旨意分给我们的。第二
，They are tools for tasks.
属灵恩赐是任务的工具。
They are not toys to entertain us.
并不是拿来使我们娱乐的玩具。
They are not trophies for us to be proud of.
它不是让我们所炫耀的奖杯。
But they are tools for us to serve this world.
可是它是让我们成为能够服侍这世界的工具。
And finally, number three.
而最后呢
？They are disciplines to be developed.
是自律的培养。
They are not some natural talent that some people just have.
它不是天生就与生俱来的才华。
They are disciplines to be developed.
是我们必须培育出来的一些纪律性的一些日常。
Today we're going to close this time with ministry.
今天我们结束我们要做服事的工作。
Last night I tried something and I'm going to do expand a little bit more on that.
昨天晚上我们尝试做了一些东西，然后今天呢我们要持续继续下去。
Shortly we'll worship the Lord.
再过一会儿呢我们要一起敬拜。
We'll ask the Holy Spirit to fill this place, fill us.
我们求主来充满这个地方，来充满我们。
But I'm going to have us minister to one another.
我们要让彼此，要彼此做服侍。
In a few different ways.
要用不同的方式。
One simple way is this.
一个很简单的方式是什么呢？
Pray for healing.
为彼此祷告医治。
Later, I'm going to ask.
等一下我就会问。
Those of us in our midst,
在我们当中
who need some kind of healing,
需要医治的。
Doesn't matter whether it's a big thing or small thing.
小病大病也好。
If you need healing,
你需要医治。
Later, I'll ask you put up your hands.
等一下就举起手，好不好？
Okay. Why?
为什么呢？
Not so that I pray for you.
不是好让我为你祷告。
Not so that I know where you are and ask you come out here.
不是让我知道你坐在哪里，然后叫你来前面。
You put up your hands so that the people around you can see that you need prayer.
你举起了手，你旁边的人看见要为你做祷告。
And those people around them,
在他们旁边的人
，You are going to pray for that healing.
你将要为他祷告医治。
The people, I know some of you, really, Pastor Masa?
啊，你就说牧师真的吗？要我这样做吗
？Later, you all really hope, the person don't lift up hand, don't lift up
hand. 旁边的人不要举手，不要举手，不要举手。
Then if you look and the person lift up the hand,
如果看到那个人举手的话
，I'll tell you something.
我要告诉你
，That means today you are chosen.
就是今天你是被拣选的啦。
God wants to work through you.
神要透过你来行大事。
So later, I want you to pray for healing.
所以等一下举手啊，我要为你祷告。
But I get it. Maybe if you pray for healing, then you are scared to pray for this person.
或许你为他祷告，然后你觉得很害怕，会不会成就呢
and you got a bit of worries or whatever.
然后你有担心，你有障碍啊。
Never mind, it's okay.
没关系的。
We want to help you develop this discipline.
我们要帮助你去培养这样的一个自律。
If the friend beside you is unwell and needs healing,
如果你旁边这个人不舒服，举起手的话。
And you want to pray for him, but you are a bit scared.
然后你要为他祷告，可是你有点害怕。
You all both come to the altar.
一起来到前面，好不好
？Okay. Not just him, both of you come.
不只是他，可是你也是要一起来前面。
Okay. You will still pray for that person.
你仍然不同的位置了，好来前面祷告。
Okay. You all still pray.
继续的祷告。
But me or one of our pastors, one of our leaders, we will join you.
可是我们其中一个牧者、组长，甚至我自己会为一起祷告。
We will stand together with you.
我们一同站立，一同祷告。
Help you grow in this area.
帮助你一起成长。
Because that's the only way we're going to learn.
因为这是我们一起来学习的唯一途径。
Sure, I can say, "Hi, you scared? Okay, lah, Pastor, we don't go and pray lah."
当然说，哎，你害怕害臊啊，韦龙牧师去吧。
But that's not what I want.
可是这不是我所要的。
I want you to take a step of faith.
我要你踏出信心的一步。
And you and the person receiving the prayer both must have faith.
然后你还有领受祷告的那个人也都要有信心。
Another thing I want to do.
另外一件事我要做的。
Let's say the person beside you.
打个比方说，你旁边的人。
Let's say didn't put out hand.
他没有举起手。
Don't need healing one lah.
不需要医治。
Oh, okay or whatever.
他 OK 的，没事的。
I also want you to pray for each other.
我也要你们彼此祷告。
But don't ask that person, how can I pray for you?
可是不要去问那个人，我能怎么样为你祷告啊？
Ask God, God, give me a word for this person.
跟上帝说，上帝，求你赐给我话语来祝福这个人。
See, a spiritual gift are words of wisdom and words of knowledge.
属灵的恩赐包括什么呢？就是知识的言语，还有智慧的言语。
You know, God can anoint you to say things that you never thought you'd say before.
神可以高牧你说出你从来未想象过能说的话。
Today is an act of faith.
今天就是信心的这个行为了。
The question now you may be wondering is like,
现在问大家的是什么呢？
You may be wondering, sure can or not?
或许你会问，啊，真的吗？可以吗？
Can I do it?
我真的能做得到吗？
I'm not Reinhard Bonnke.
我不是布永康牧师。
I'm not Cho Yong Gi.
我不是赵荣基。
I'm not Pastor Caesar.
我不是凯撒牧师。我不是匡牧师。
I'm not Pastor Jenny, Pastor Wilong, Pastor Richard, whoever.
我不是我，总之我不是牧师。这么多名字一次过讲就好了啦，哇啦，麻烦呢你。
Let me read to you one very powerful part of 1 Corinthians 12.
让我来为你读哥林多前书第十二章非常重要、非常有能力的一段话。
1 Corinthians 12 verses 4 to 6.
第四章到第六章。
There are different kinds of gifts.But the same Spirit distributes them. There are different kinds of service, but the same Lord. There are different kinds of working, but in all of them, in everyone, it is the same God at work.
恩赐原有分别，圣灵却是一位；执事也有分别，主却是一位；功用也有分别，神却是一位。在众人里面运行一切的事。
When you look at this from a literary point of view,
当你从一个直接读的这个概念来说，
you see three repetitions there.
你就会看见重复性的有三段话。
Same Spirit, same Lord, same God.
同一位的圣灵，一位的主，一位的神。
Today, can you step out in faith and see miracles?
今天你能信心踏出看见神迹吗？
Of course can.
当然可以。
It doesn't matter that you're not Reinhard Bonnke.
你不是布永康不要紧。
It doesn't matter that you're not Apostle Paul.
你不是使徒保罗不要紧的。
It doesn't matter that you're not Moses.
你不是摩西不要紧的。
It doesn't matter that you're not Jesus.
你不是耶稣不要紧的。
Because you have the same Spirit, the same Lord, and the same God.
因为你有同一位圣灵，你有同一位主，你有同一位神。
And if we ever think I cannot do it because I'm not like so and so,
如果你觉得我不像某某人，我做不到这样的事，
that means you don't believe that we have the same God.
那你就是不相信我们有同一位神。
But church, today I'm telling you.
可是教会今天我要告诉你，
we have the same God at work.
我们有同样的神在我们当中。
Today we're going to pray for each other.
今天我们要为彼此祷告。
Because you know, if I can bring people to the front.
当然，我可以邀请大家来到前面来。
We have maybe 5 or 10 pastors and leaders on duty.
或许我们有5到10位牧者准备随时为你祷告。
That's about 5 to 10 people praying.
最多就是5到10个人正在祷告。
5 to 10 people, maybe 20 people receiving prayer.
可能或者是5到10到20个人在领受祷告。
But if every single Christian moves in the gifts of the Holy Spirit,
可是如果每一位基督徒都按着圣灵的恩赐在运行的话，
at this service alone, we have maybe about 1,500-1,600 people praying to other people.
在这里，在家中，在这个聚会，可能有1,500到600个人在同时间祷告。
And this is how the world will experience the reality of God.
而世界就会经历到神的真实。
Not just because we bring them into the church,
不单单是因为我们将他们带到教会来，
but because the church brings the reality of God out there,
而是因为教会将神的真实带出去。
So we're going to respond today.
所以今天我们要做回应。
Let me invite all of us, let's stand right now.
邀请大家站立起来。
Both here and over there at Suntec,
在这里也在新达城也在家中的你们。
We'll just worship the Lord for a short moment before we have this time of ministry.
我们花一点时间，我们来敬拜主。
But as we enter this time of worship,
可是我们进入这敬拜的时间，
I want to ask you that in your own way, just say, Lord, use me.
好不好？我们用自己的方式说，主啊，求你使用我。
Today, you know God wants to use you.
今天我要告诉你，神要大大使用你。
Doesn't matter, you young, you old, you new Christian, you old Christian, doesn't matter.
你年轻也好，你年长也好，你在教会多久都好。
We have the same God.
我们有同一位神。
So as we worship this song,
所以当我们敬拜的时候。
Cry out for God to use you.
打从心里面向神呼求。
And after that, we'll pray for each other.
然后我们要彼此祷告。
Let's lift up our hands.
好不好？举起我们的手。
Let's worship the Lord.
我们一起来敬拜主。
Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, come, Holy Spirit.Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit, we know you're here.
圣灵啊，我们知道你在我们当中。
I ask that you anoint your people, empower each and every one of them.
求你高莫还有加添能力在每个人的身上。
At a moment's time when we pray for one another.
再过一会儿，当我们为彼此祷告的时候。
We pray not out of our own strength or ability.
我们祷告不透过自己的能力或者是自己的力量。
We pray through the power of your Holy Spirit.
我们透过圣灵的大能来祷告。
Today we pray that this will be the day of breakthroughs.
我们祷告今天将会是充满突破的一天。
This will be the day of open doors.
进入打开所有的门的一天。
Because we have risen up in faith.
因为我们凭信心已经兴起来了。
So church, I speak this faith.
所以教会，我宣告这份信心在你心里面。
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You can put your hands down for now.
好，你首先放下来。
I want to release some words from our intercessors.
我要释放啊，我们的祷告勇士的一些所释放的话语。
The Lord, of course, want to bring healing today.
神今天要带来医治。
People who have back pain and particularly in the spine.
背部尤其是靠近那个脊椎骨的部分的。
Some are having abdominal issues. The Lord wants to bring healing.
有些人的胃部、腹部有不适，神要医治。
Those with heart conditions.
心脏有问题的。
And those who are struggling with insomnia,
还有缺乏睡或者是失眠的这个状态。
The Lord wants to heal you in this area.
神今天要祝福你能够睡得甘甜。
So these are the words for healing.
这些就是医治的方面的话语。
So if any of you, these words are for you.
如果今天这些话跟你说话了。
Or you need healing in any other way.
又或者你在我们没有列出来，可是你觉得你知道你需要医治的。
Can you lift up your hand right now?
举起手好不好？
Here and over at Suntec as well.
在这边也在新达成，我看到你们举起手了。
Okay, the people around them.
在他们旁边的人。
You're the chosen ones.
你们就是被拣选的。
Okay, so you all remember now.
所以现在记住了。
Okay, you can put your hands down.
好，手放下。
And like I said, if you all need someone to pray for you, come forward and we'll get pastors and leaders to pray with you all.
你还有你身边的人，如果你需要别人一起祷告的话，就来前面，有牧者为你们一起祷告。
Are there some other words here?
有其他的话语。
The Lord wants to minister to those who have financial issues.
神要服侍那些在经济上有困难的人。
Some you're afraid of failure.
你害怕失败。
That's why you don't dare to step out in faith.
所以你不敢凭信心踏出来。
Today, take the step of faith to pray or receive that prayer.
今天凭信心踏出来领受祷告。
Some of us here, we need to walk away from sin.
当中有人必须远离罪恶。
It's time to walk with the Spirit.
是时候与圣灵同行了。
Some of us here, you fear spiritual gifts.
当中有人他们害怕圣灵的恩赐。
It could be because of your past spiritual or other religious experiences.
可能是因为你以前其他信仰的那些经历。
Today, the Lord wants to set you free.
今天神要大大的释放你。
And lastly, someone here, An intercessor saw the numbers 10 and 84.
我们当中有祷，我们的祷告勇士看见两个号码，第一个号码是十，第二个号码是八十四。
It's not for you to buy whatever.
不是买什么hing hing, 不是。
These numbers are special to somebody here.
可是对某一个人，这些号码特别有
The Lord wants you to know that he loves you.
神要告诉你，他爱你。
So the worship team will continue singing.
所以我们敬拜队会继续唱诗歌。
Wherever we are, here Suntec, begin to pray for one another.
在这里，在新达城，在家的继续祷告。
Even if it's not healing, pray over whatever the Lord has placed upon your heart.
如果健康没事，也要彼此祷告。
If you got specific needs, ask them to pray for that also.
如果你有确切的祷告需求，也可以分享。
And if you need someone to stand together with you, you all come to the front.
如果你需要人陪同你祷告，可以来到前面。
We'll pray together.
我们一起
祷告。So let's begin to pray right now, all over here and over there at Suntec. Let's begin to pray.
在这里，在新达城，在家中。
Everybody pray for somebody.
大家找一个人祝。祝福他帮他一起祷告
And the pastors and leaders on duty, we have some groups who are at the front. Let's pray together with them.
牧者和领袖们，我们有弟兄姊妹需要祷告，你也可以来到前面来帮忙。
Come forward and help us.
我们需要姊妹的组长领袖来前上前来祷告。
Longing for your anointing to fall on me, let it fall from heaven, Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit.Come home, Spirit.
喜是你，全心和睦你，我仰望你，敬拜屈膝是你，全心等候你，我只想等
Those of us here and over there at Suntec, you're still receiving prayer.
我知道很多人还在领受祷告。
If you're receiving prayer, just continue to receive that prayer.
请继续不要停哈。
But the rest of us, why don't you lift up our hands to the Lord?
我们其余的人好不好？我们都举起我们的手。
I want to speak these words over you.
我要宣告神的话语。
That the Spirit of the Lord is upon you.
主的灵在我身上。
Because He has anointed you to proclaim good news to the poor.
因为他用膏膏了你，叫你传福音给贫穷的人。
He is sending you to proclaim freedom to the prisoners.
他差遣你报告被掳的得释放。
He is sending you to heal the sick.
他差遣你使瞎眼得看见。
He is sending you to set the oppressed free.
他差遣你叫那受压制的得自由。
He is sending you to proclaim His favor.
他差遣你去报告神约那人的喜年。
So I speak this upon each and every one of you.
我宣告这段话语在每个人的身上。
That church you would rise up in faith.
教会你会凭信心兴起来。
That you would desire spiritual gifts.
你会切慕属灵恩赐。
Not for our own.
不是为着自己所要的，
而
是好让我们去服侍身边人。
So the Lord says He is with you.
所以神说他与你同在。
The Lord says you are anointed.
神说你是受膏抹的。
So today move in the anointing.
今天你要凭按着圣灵的感动跟膏抹运行。
He has given you that spirit of power.
他已经赐给你那个大能的灵。
So move in that power.
所以你在那个灵里面运行吧。
So I bless you with this.
所以我要祝福你们。
In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray.
奉主耶稣基督的大名祷告。
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If you still need ministry or they pray for, you can remain here.
我们不着急，如果你还需要接受祷告，请继续。
But the rest of you, God bless you, you are dismissed.
其余的人，神祝福你们，我们下星期见。